And our fourth main topic today gets submitted to us by Darren Fiesen, who writes, "Hey, John and Rob. Okay, guys, Loki is now here with glorious purpose." That's actually the name of the first episode. "I loved it so much. Just one episode in, and it's already my favorite of the MCU Disney Plus shows. I know you guys gave us your quick reactions before, but I wanted to know your more in-depth thoughts now that the first episode is out. Thank you, and bring on the filthy." All right, thanks a lot for sending that in. And yeah, look, there's no other way to put it. Loki was fantastic. It's fantastic. It again is very different than the tone and nature of WandaVision. It's totally different from the tone and nature of Falcon and the Winter Soldier. It has taken this character Loki and the MCU into no places it has ever been before. Like when we first realized that the TVA, the Time Variance Authority, was going to be a part of it, it's like, oh, well, that's new. They've never done that. I'm not going to give away any spoilers. But, oh my goodness, you don't realize how big the implications are to the MCU as a whole that the Time Variance Authority is here. And when you're watching this episode, you're like, wow, this is actually very, very big and very, very important. But for me, Rob, there was so much to love in this episode, but you and I were talking off screen before the show started. And there is a scene that is in the trailers where you see Loki and you see Morpheus? No. What's his name? Morbius? No, that's not Morbius. Morbius is
Morbius. Yeah, Morbius.
It is Agent Morbius.
Mobius.
Mobius, that's it.
Mobius. Like so, a Mobius loop.
Yeah, so Agent Mobius, played by Owen Wilson, and Loki, played by Tom Hiddleston. You see them sitting down in that room talking in the trailers. Well, in that scene, near the end of episode one, and again, I'm not going to spoil and say what happens or what is said, but there is dialogue. You know what it reminded me of, Rob? One of my favorite movies ever, which is The King's Speech. And what I loved about The King's Speech is a lot of the best and most important parts of that movie is just two men sitting in a room talking together. The scenes where you have Colin Firth and Jeffrey Rush just sitting in the room talking to each other is some of the most riveting stuff, pardon me, I've seen on the big screen in a long time. And there's a scene similar to that that we see hinted at in the trailers of Owen Wilson and Tom Hiddleston sitting there talking, and near the end of episode one, some of the most truly profound, deep character work that's ever been done in the MCU is done in this episode. And it's fun. It's laugh out loud in some places. It's not a huge actioneer. The first episode is not a big action thing or anything like that. It's just fantastic. And I got to tell you, man, I loved it. There's also a scene, again, I won't spoil what it is, guys, but there is a scene where Loki is stumbling around and he opens some random drawer that just made me like laugh my guts out. And you'll see what I mean once you see the episode. Again, I just thought it was incredible. Wonderful character work. Owen Wilson is fantastic. Tom Hiddleston is fantastic. Some deep, deep character dive stuff. The best look we've ever had at the character of Loki. And by the way, Noah AG Official sends in a super chat badge in the live chat. Thank you, man. I appreciate that. It's just phenomenal. And believe me when I tell you, because I've seen the second episode, which I won't talk about, but the second episode only gets better. But anyway, I absolutely loved it. Rob, you had a chance now to sit down and watch the first episode of Loki, also known as Glorious Purpose. What did you think of it?
I watched it twice. I loved it. And what I marveled at, so to speak, I didn't plan that. I just said it. The idea of taking let's call it a very wacky idea, like the Time Variance Authority. One of the things that I've marveled at about the Marvel Universe is the first Iron Man film was a very down-to-earth, it was as realistic an affair as they could. Sure, the Iron Man suit and the way it worked is their big ask in that movie, but it really was about one man coming to terms with himself and his responsibility to his fellow man and himself. And the battle was between him his own soul. And then, of course, the external battle was between his mentor and fighting for control of his own company. It was not apocalyptic. You know, it was the story of an individual. And now that we've moved all the way past the Infinity Saga to introduce, I mean, throughout the Marvel Universe, you get Asgard, you get the Guardians of the Galaxy, you get the cosmic nature of the Marvel Universe, and now we've got with the Eternals, the Celestials coming, and things are just getting bigger and bigger and bigger and more sci-fi fantasy, more removed from the original Iron Man 1 as possible. I marveled at how they took influences from things like Brazil and the Adjustment Bureau, and they really had a lot of fun with the Time Variance Authority, which, again, is something that comes right out of the comics. And they made it something that it seemed like it worked within the MCU, which is crazy. I mean, this is as far out as the MCU has gone. And yet, at the same time, this is, again, a story about Loki coming to terms with himself. And there were moments like there's an extended scene in this episode where Owen Wilson, like you said, and Tom Hiddleston as Loki are just talking. And Owen Wilson is asking Loki very important, very pointed questions about himself. You know, basically, why do you do what you do? Please explain it to me. And like you said, it's character defining, and it's coming to grips with you know, asking those tough choices. And it's very introspective, and I thought it was really interesting. And for me, John, you know, I'm always going character, character, character. And there's so much about Loki as a character in this film that is adult, it is nuanced, it is fascinating to watch, and yet it has all of the fact that they've gone so far out into the realm of comic book fantasy sci-fi and yet made it have this kind of an emotional wallop, I was astonished by it, knocked out by it. And I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people that are going to complain, but now it's gotten to the point where people just, I think, have their knives sharpened just because. And no one, again, is actually paying attention to what's going on. And I think that this show, it's brought really interesting elements of time travel, the idea of fate and destiny. Are we in control of our lives or are we not? And I think that's going to be a big, as the series moves forward, that's going to be a big question. Do our lives matter? You know, if everything is predetermined, and that's what's been so great about time travel stories, are our lives predetermined or do we have choice? And I think that's part of what this show is ultimately going to be about, because that's what the character of Loki is facing. What is the choice? Who am I based on the choices, the sum total of the choices I've made? And I think that's fascinating stuff to deal with in a comic book TV series.
There's it's not to spoil anything. I will tell you one line that is in the series, and it's a question. So this isn't a line that reveals something big, okay? But it's Owen Wilson talking to Loki, and he simply asks him the question that is, do you enjoy hurting people? And that just illustrates the type of character work they do with Loki and the soul exposing that they do of Loki in this. It's a scene that I loved. It kind of just represented the entire episode to me, with a lot of, you know, the jovialness of the Loki character that we love so much, but then it gets dead serious. And man, I'm telling you, I loved this episode so much. I think it's my favorite premiere of the three Disney Plus series we've had so far.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I really like the first episode of WandaVision and the first episode of Falcon Winter Soldier, but this is I think this is the best one they've done yet. As far, I don't know if it's going to go on and be the best show they've done, but as far as one episode goes, that's why I feel bad. Now, listen, guys, I just want to remind you that today at 4 p.m., so you still got like 5 hours to go and watch Loki if you want, but today at 4 p.m., we are going to be doing an open spoiler discussion about Loki where we'll go into all the details about it that you guys want to talk about. The event is posted on the YouTube channel right now, so you can see it there. You can wait for it. You can go over there, start talking to each other right now, but we'll do that at 4 p.m. today. Anyway, the question for you guys is, have you had a chance to watch the episode one premiere of Loki, Glorious Purpose? If so, what did you guys think about it? Jump on down into the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. Okay, guys.